Good morning to all of you. My presentation is on steroid-induced glaucoma after kidney transplant patients. So coming to introduction, the chronic kidney disease globally, it poses a significant morbidity and mortality. The prevalence of CKD has been estimated as 800 per million population according to an estimate. And incidence of end-stage renal disease has been estimated as 150 to 200 per million population according to an estimate, which require kidney transplant and or dialysis. So coming to kidney transplant and immunosuppression, kidney transplantation is a treatment of choice for patients with end-stage renal disease. However, these patients require prolonged immunosuppression, and it is the key for it is a major key for successful transplantation. So these immunosuppressants are largely comprised of systemic steroid, cyclosporin, tacrolimus, mycophenolate, mofetil, azathioprine. Immunosuppressants are associated with a lot of adverse effects, including ophthalmological manifestations. So there have been very few studies showing the pattern of steroid-induced glaucoma in patients with kidney transplant recipient, particularly from India. So our aim was to provide the incidence of steroid-induced glaucoma in these patients and also the treatment characteristic in these patients receiving kidney transplant. Also, we studied the other ophthalmological finding in these patients. So coming to method, it was a cross-sectional study. So we did the prospective enrollment of patients who underwent kidney transplantation, and these were on routine follow-up at nephrology department of our institute. The study was conducted for 1 year, and necessary clearances were obtained for this study. So coming to immunosuppressant regimen, all patients received the induction regimen injection methylprednisolone. And the maintenance regimen was comprised of steroid, tacrolimus, and mycophenolate. So all patients underwent comprehensive ophthalmic evaluation, including slit lamp biomicroscopy, IOP with Goldman applanation tonometer. And we assessed the number of patients with glaucoma. So cases with intraocular pressure more than 21 millimeter mercury associated with visual field defect, optic disc cupping or asymmetry of 0.2 or more. Ocular hypertension was designated as patients with intraocular pressure more than 21 millimeter of mercury with normal visual field. Also, the other ocular disorders were noted in these patients. So coming to statistical, we also did a relationship between doses, duration, and number of days with high dose steroid, and association of these with cataract and ocular hypertension and glaucoma was also studied using necessary tests. Coming to results, so we had 72 patients in which the mean age was 39 year approximately, and the males were more common as compared to females. The mean follow-up was 30 months. And coming to etiology, so diabetic nephropathy was the most common cause of chronic kidney disease or end-stage renal disease in our patients. Next was the chronic glomerulonephritis, and the rest one, the tubular interstitial nephritis and idiopathic. So steroid-induced glaucoma was seen in 7 patients. It was around 9.72%. Ocular hypertension was seen in 9 patients. And the cataract was the most common complication we have seen in around 30 patients. That was around 41.67%. So rest were the hypertensive retinopathy, diabetic retinopathy, and branched retinal vein occlusion. Coming to treatment characteristic, 3 patients received anti-glaucoma medication to control intraocular pressure. 4 patients required trabeculectomy for further control of intraocular pressure. Now coming to relation of steroid doses and glaucoma. So the total dose was significantly higher in patients who developed glaucoma and ocular hypertension and cataract as compared to patients who did not develop these complications. Also, the number of days were significantly higher. The patients who received high dose steroid for days and as compared to patients who did not develop glaucoma or cataract complication. Now coming to discussion. So we reported ocular complications in around 50% of patients with kidney transplant. This was similar to a case series from India, which also reported the incidence of ocular abnormality in 52.5% patients. The incidence of cataract in our series, the cataract was the most common complication encountered in around 41.67% of patients. So the incidence of cataract has varied from 23 to 62.5% in various earlier series. Now coming to ocular hypertension, it was the next most common steroid-related ophthalmic complication. It was encountered in 12.5% patients. This was similar to another previous study was Simeu et al. And a high incidence of ocular hypertension has also been reported in around 47% of patients in a series of 15 patients receiving kidney transplant recipient. Now coming to glaucoma, we had seven patients with steroid-induced glaucoma in which visual field defects were also there. And another recently published 10-year analysis of eyesight, which reported incidence of glaucoma 16%. So coming to conclusion, kidney transplant recipient must be screened periodically for any ophthalmic complication as their timely intervention can preserve or improve the vision. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Mehwo.
Thank you.
Judges, questions, please. Welcome in.
Dr. Vaibhav, do you think this rise in pressure after steroid use is reversible after the steroids are stopped, or every patient will ultimately go on to get a trabeculectomy or any surgery for that matter?
Ma'am, we have seen in some patients it is reversible, because if you lower down the doses of steroid, the pressure comes down in some patients. But in advanced cases, it is generally irreversible, so you require ultimate. Mostly patients are on low dose steroid, receiving kidney transplant patient after 6 months to 1 year. They are on around 10 mg or 5 mg of steroid mostly.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Patients, those patients who needed a surgery and all, they were diagnosed late or this was inadvertent?
Mostly patients, ma'am, they were on the, though we have not analyzed the cause of this thing, but mostly they were on the high doses of steroid and also presented late to us.